My name is Tyler. We are going to be looking at ViacomCBS because they were up over 9% today, and they do have a high short interest, and there is relatively low news. But for those of you guys that don't know what ViacomCBS is, I am going to be explaining in detail why they are so undervalued. Now, you guys might know ViacomCBS from running up from about $40 a share all the way up to $100 and then dropping over 50% of their value back down to about $38 per share. Now they're currently up to $41.64 per share, and I think this is a far cry from where their true fair value lies. So we're going to be going over this in detail. If you guys like this kind of content, hit the like button, comment down below, subscribe to the channel, and if you want to stay up to date with all of these stocks that we all love, make sure to hit the notification bell so you will be notified every single time a video is posted. Taking a brief look at what ViacomCBS stock did today, we could see in pre-market, along with a lot of other oversold, more hype stocks, they were down in pre-market, not as bad as some other ones, down about 0.40%, and then just started melting up and then subsequently ripping up the rest of the day, closing up over 9% up. So this is quite incredible. I could not find any definitive news, but there is some contributing factors that I am going to blame to this rally we've seen today. So one of them is the short volume ratio is at 20%, and this is 420. And if you guys don't know, a quick background, Fintel, they update the short volume ratio. So the percentage of shares on the total volume of that stock for any particular day, they keep track of how many of those out of that one day are sold short. So 20% of the shares yesterday were sold short. But if you come down on Fintel's website, you can also see how much of the percentage of shares of the total volume are sold short every single day. And this is updated every single day. I don't know why it is not updated for today. Every single stock I've checked is not updated for today. So, but you could see it's anywhere in between a low of 12% and a high of about 21%. So we do have a significant short interest. I would estimate it's anywhere between 15 and 16%, just doing some rough estimations here. But that is relatively high, nothing to cause a significant short squeeze. We could see a 5 to 10% move up like we did, and that could be part of what is going on right now. But just taking a look, see, there's nothing that is really a big headliner as far as news is related. There's a lot of old stuff, but nothing for today that would constitute this run that we've seen in the share price today. But one article in particular I do want to take a look at. This was one that was posted today, and it is from CNA Finance, and I do like their perspective on a lot of different stocks and investment styles. I think they're just more down to what is actually going on in the company. So ViacomCBS, Viacom stock is going to pop. Like I said, this is from April 21st, so today. It says ViacomCBS has had a rough go in the market as of late. In late March, the stock plummeted after the company said it would be selling about $3 billion worth of its common stock in an attempt to raise funds to enter into the streaming industry. And if we all know, people are cutting the cord, they're getting rid of cable, they're switching to streaming platforms, and not usually just one, Netflix, Disney, or whatever, Discovery Plus. They're switching to quite a few at a time. So there's going to be multiple winners in this streaming war that we see going on right now. But anyways, with that being said, they said they would be selling $3 billion worth of stock, which is relatively low if we consider their total market cap is $27 billion. So that is around, I mean, that's still about 10% of their total market cap. But this is not bad, guys. This is actually a very, very good thing that they are selling stock to put it back into Paramount Plus, which is their streaming platform that they launch, as well as they do have Pluto Plus, and we'll get into that more in a second. But they are putting this money into streaming and making their own original content. And one of the biggest things that I love about Paramount Plus is they have some of your hottest cable channels, cable series that have ever been produced. Like, they have the CBS, BET, Comedy Central, Nickelodeon, MTV, Smithsonian Channel. So they have a good mix of kid content. As far as Nickelodeon is concerned, they have every single Nickelodeon episode, series, any of that. And then they do have more adult-related content, like the old MTVs, Comedy Central, BET, and they even have the news and the sports and some of that stuff. So there's basically something here for everybody, and they do have a large variety of content, as well as they have their original content, which does, I mean, look very good. I can't really judge a book by its cover too much, because these could be bad shows, but they do look good, and this is really what they're trying to push out, is their original content. So this is very good. This is pretty much what Netflix did, but they're trying to do it at an exponentially faster pace. So as well as that, they do have a lot of these sports that are hard to find on regular channels. Like, they have golf, Champions League, so like soccer, March Madness, SEC, and NFL, as well as obviously CBS, CBN, CBS This Morning, 60 Minutes, a lot of popular news stations and programs as well. And then this is where I think the real gold is, because the only company that can compete with Paramount Plus as far as a not even adult content, but kids content in general, is Disney Plus. But Paramount Plus has hits like SpongeBob, iCarly, Henry Danger, Paw Patrol, Dora, Peppa Pig, Blue's Clues, and the list pretty much goes on and on. If you can think of anything Nickelodeon, they have it on this channel. So, or on this program, I should say. So that is very good. And the mix that they have, the adult content, really makes Paramount Plus a true winner, in my opinion. So they obviously can do two different packages as well. So the first plan starts at $5.99 a month, and that is basically with limited ads. So not as much as what is on TV, but you still do get ads here and there. And then they have the $9.99 package, which is no ads. And both of these are good. I do like the fact they have two different plans. I think that is highly beneficial to people maybe that want the program that can't really afford it. So that is very good. And if we come back to the stock price, and I do have a position in this I will go over in 1 second, but since they announced this in around February, really when they started to rip up and go into somewhat of a short squeeze, they're trading at about the same price as they were when they announced this. So around late January, around like $45, they're currently at $41. So it's fallen pretty much under or right to the price of the day that they announced this Paramount Plus streaming program. And this just launched, Paramount Plus launched March 4th. So this is a very new streaming service, so we have not got too much numbers about their actual users that they have signed up or anything related to that. We did find out they had 19 million users sign up in the first 2 weeks, so that is very good if it shows you any kind of trajectory going forward. Disney Plus is at almost 100 million paid subscribers, and we will know that once their earnings come out next week, I believe. But they nevertheless in the first 2 weeks have done almost 20% of what Disney Plus has done in almost 2 years now, a year and a half. That is very good in my opinion. And if, like I said, you come back and consider the $27 billion market cap, I do think this stock is grossly undervalued. And just to save you guys the time and just tell you guys this upfront, I did the math in one of my last videos, which you guys should check out, about CBS stock about a week ago. They have a 9.5% profit margin. So they have plenty of money to continue piling into their streaming services, which they spend about $15 billion a year in streaming content alone. And the fact that they pay a 2.5% dividend is absolutely awesome. I do expect this dividend to go away though, just because I feel like they're going to go into more of a growth style, and having a dividend and trying to grow is kind of conflicting. You really don't want to do that. You want to put as much money into the business and grow that as much as possible. But if you even come right here, I know Robinhood's not too updating as far as like these metrics right here, employees, price to earnings ratio. But if you come to the price to earnings ratio, it is at 9.80. And that is very, very low. Like, if you consider this a growth stock, which I do now because of Paramount Plus, their revenue is going to be growing on the top and bottom line quite a bit. A 9.8% price to earnings ratio is stupidly low. Like any growth stock, like your Apple or Microsoft, is going to be about 30 to 40 price to earnings ratio. So that is basically timesing how much money they make per year into what the share price is. So I do think this is grossly undervalued at this point. And I do want to point out my position really quick. I have the Viacom $70 calls. I bought these at I bought the one at $530 April 5th. And then I bought this last one April 9th at $385. And I do think this is very great. I think it's a steal ultimately when it comes down to it. In 2023, these are going to be worth quite a bit of money. I'm very certain about that, but I'm down almost 29% on these, so it's still a good time to get into this. And this is one of the main reasons why I made this video, is just because of what a steal these options are at, considering how much this company could grow, given they're only at a $27 billion market cap, which is super, super low for the kind of money this company can start bringing in. And they have already brought in. I mean, this company rakes in billions of dollars in profit a year. So, and has had a very long standing dividend. So, very, very good there. And I do want to point out as well, the fair value on Robinhood. If you guys follow this or know anything about Robinhood and their fair value, they usually undershoot this. And the fact that they're at $61 as their fair value for, ViacomCBS, that is about 30% lower than where they're at right now. So if that tells you anything, this stock definitely has room to fly. Now, I do want to get into the technical analysis because this does look very good as well. Now, as to the technical analysis, this is the biggest thing I want to point out for you guys because I think it is absolutely ridiculous. So ViacomCBS is currently at $41.64. So that puts us precisely at, hold on, I didn't have my thing on, $41, what did I say, 64 cents. That puts us precisely at January 14th. That will just tell you how bad and oversold this stock is. So I would, like I said, imagine there is a lot of short sellers that just beat down the stock, and we even went as low as $37 a share, and this is absolutely ridiculous, guys. This is basically considering Paramount Plus added zero value to ViacomCBS, and that is just simply not the case. So if we do zoom it into a closer level, it does look like we could get a little bit of resistance around the $46 mark. Actually, more around the $47 mark, because that is where we really sold off around March 31st. And that is where we just get into way oversold territory. And as always, on the RSI, I do want to point out we are overbought. But this basically measures how fast the move comes. So if we slowly sell off like we have been, we really don't go into oversold territory, besides this one day we had a bigger sell-off, and the one day that we do pop up a lot, 9%, we go into overbought territory. So that is one reason why I don't like the RSI, the relative strength index, just because it's so flawed sometimes. It really means nothing when it comes down to it. Now, do I think ViacomCBS is actually worth $100 a share? Probably not right now, but you could make the argument that if you obviously like the stock market price in future growth, you can make the argument that they are worth $100 a share right now. That is just pricing in a couple years of good growth, or depending how fast they do grow, hopefully less than that, right? But if we do come out, our obvious support level is going to be around the $37 mark, and I just don't see us getting back down to here. I think really if you bought in even now, this is a really, really good price. I think the more or less the fair value is around $65 to $70 a share in this stock. But if I were to imagine we're going to go through a little bit of consolidation period, and then we're going to gap up, like I said, to around the $47 mark, consider, I know this is really bad way to draw it, but something like this, a stair step motion back up, because it is unsustainable to continuously gap up day after day. You have to have a consolidation period to really find the bottom and then push higher. So that is what I'm looking at right now. Long story short, out of this whole video, ViacomCBS is a great stock to buy right now that is more on the safe side because, one, they pay a dividend and their valuation is just stupidly low at $27 billion, but it does offer a big amount of growth if Paramount Plus does really good. And I also do want to point out their earnings are May 6th, so we could get a little bit of information as far as their subscriber growth before this, but I don't expect to. I really think it's going to come around May 6th, and I think we will have a good earnings at ViacomCBS because we will have a good 2 months of paid subscribers at Paramount Plus. And I actually heard about this at work through my coworkers. So whenever you hear that, you want to take note about it, do your research and follow up, because if people are talking about it in person, odds are more people are talking about it around the world or wherever the program is, more people are talking about it. So that is basically my thesis on ViacomCBS, why I think it's undervalued. That is my trade. Nothing is a recommendation. Do your own research, come to your own conclusions as always, but I do think this is a pretty much hands down win if you ask me. So that is what I am looking at. There could be a little short squeeze here. I don't expect anything too crazy. We might have got most of that move today. Fintel has not updated as of right now, so I'm not exactly sure. Oh, okay, it did just update. We're still at 20% for the day, so not much has actually changed. That's surprising they updated it at almost 11 o'clock, but still 20%, so that is extremely elevated. Like I said, we could have a little short squeeze, but I don't expect anything too crazy. This is more of a long-term trade with options. I'm not interested in the shares, really. The options are how I am playing it. So if you guys got anything useful out of the video, hit the like button, subscribe, and consider hitting the notification bell if you want to stay up to date with all of these videos as soon as they're posted. I will see you guys later. Peace out.